We pray that you give us insights, bring clarity through your word. And as we seek your face in prayer, let there be a great change in our lives. We return all glory and honor to your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I break out of captivity. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, let me begin by saying that many people are captives of the devil without their knowledge. There are many people who are captives of the enemy without their knowledge. You can be in church and yet you are a captive in the camp of the enemy. You can be in a church, you can be very much committed in church, but yet still, you are a captive in the camp of the enemy. There are two types of captivity. I'll go a little bit fast. There are two types of captivity. There is what we call personal captivity. Personal captivity. What is personal captivity? This is whereby an individual is being under the grip of darkness. Personal captivity is talking about individual. This is a case, a scenario wherein a person is under the entanglement of the devil. That is personal captivity. There is also what we call collective captivity. Collective captivity. What is collective captivity? Collective captivity is the kind of captivity that entangled an entire family. This kind of captivity is going after a generation, not a man. Collective captivity is after an entire household. Hear this, somebody. That is why when you look at some family, everyone is going through a kind of deficiency. You check some family, the same pattern in the father, you can see the trace in the children. The same habit of the mother, you can see the same trace in the lives of the children. In some family, the father is a drunkard, and all the male children, they are drunkard also. In some families, the mother is a smoker, and when you check the lives of the children, all of them, they are smoking. That is collective captivity. Same habits, one family. I pray for somebody watching me today. Yes, I pray for somebody listening to me today. Yes, every form of captivity, yes, whether they are personal or collective, yes, you are breaking out in the name of Jesus. Yes. I say you are breaking out in the name of Jesus. Yes. Every form of captivity, yes, whether they are personal captivity, yes, you are coming out of it tonight in Jesus' name. Yes. If they are collective captivity, yes, if it is a captivity that affects the entire family, yes, you are breaking out by the blood of Jesus. Amen. Collective and personal captivity. Another name for captivity is bondage. When we say somebody is a captive, it means you are in bondage. Another name for captivity is bondage. And listen to me, when somebody is a captive, that person is automatically a prisoner. If you are a captive of the enemy, that has made you a prisoner to the enemy. We have so many unconscious prisoners. There are many people, they are prisoners of the devil, they don't know. Yes? There are many Christians, there are many people in church, they are prisoners of the enemy without their knowledge. They think they are enjoying life, but they are prisoners to sex. Look at me. When you meet a young man that has great potential, but all they spend their life doing, their time doing, is to run behind ladies. They think they're enjoying life. In our generation, they will see you as a smart guy. They see you as the coolest guy around. Little did they know that they are prisoners of the devil. When you meet a young lady that is beautiful, that has potentials of greatness, and yet she is around sleeping with all manner of men, some people look at you, they might think you are the best lady around. They admire your beauty. They say, the baby is nice. She's looking well. And because of that, every man is coming after you. Everybody is seeking after your number. And you are available for every Jack and Jill. Can I shock you? You are a prisoner of sin. You are a prisoner of sex. When you meet a young man that is behind alcohol all the days of his life, you meet some people today, hear this now. You meet some people today, the sooner they collect their salary, they can spend half of it in alcohol. Yet they feel they're enjoying life. There are many unconscious prisoners today.
They feel they are enjoying life, but they are under the captivity of the enemy. I don't know if there is any member in your family whose life is like that. Yes, that feels they are enjoying life, but they are being under the captivity of the devil. Yes. As a reason of your prayers tonight, may they break out of that captivity in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Many unconscious captives and prisoners walking around. Prisoners of sex. Prisoners of alcohol. Prisoners of smoking. Prisoners of pornography. You meet them all around. You meet some nice, decent people. They can't sleep without watching pornography. I've met intelligent people. When you see them, you admire them. But they can't live life without pornography. I met a young lady married to a lawyer in this country. A big lawyer in this country. And she was telling me that my husband can't sleep with me except we watch pornography together. I said, for what? He said, without watching pornographic movie, I can't have pleasure for my wife. That is satanic. That is evil. There is somebody watching me today. I don't know which manner of captivity your life is under. As a result of us praying tonight, I don't know which area you notice you are in bondage. I don't know which area you notice that your family has been in captivity. But as we pray today, as we raise our voice and pray today, I see God sending help for you in the name of Jesus. I say the Lord will send help for you in the name of Jesus. Psalm 126 verse 1. Psalm 126 verse 1. Bible says that when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. God is in the habit of turning captivity around. That's why I want to encourage you to pray tonight. When God turned again the captivity, there is someone watching at me tonight. There is going to be a turning to your captivity tonight. I said there is going to be a turning to every captivity in your life tonight. If you are the one I'm talking to, can you shout the loudest? Amen.
Amen.
Many people are unconsciously captives of the devil. I will not have time to go over and over and over again. There are many people I have met. They are captives to sin. They are captives to sin. They engage in things that they know will destroy them, but they can't let go of those things. You meet some married women. They are married, but they just can't stay with their husband. They feel like having extra marital relationship out there. My sister, you need to pray tonight. They have a fiancé that has so much faith in them. Believe that we are going to settle together, and yet they are out there messing up their lives. They are captives to sin. I'm not here tonight to judge you. I'm here to encourage you to pray. If you fall under this category, you must be ready to pray tonight that God will turn that captivity around. I don't know how you entered into the captivity. I don't know how you became a prisoner to the camp of the devil. But as you raise your voice tonight, when God turns again, look, the Lord is going to turn again your captivity in Jesus' name. I said Jehovah is going to turn again your captivity in Jesus' name. Many people are captives to sin. Many people are captives to sickness. You can be a captive to sickness. Medically, you've made every effort, but you are never getting well. My brother, you must pray tonight. My sister, you must pray tonight. Sickness you never imagine. Going to the hospital now, they are telling you that you have this kind of sickness. Don't take it lightly. The devil wants you to be a captive to sickness. That's why when you go to some Christian homes, all manner of medicine is in their house. There are some mini clinics in the house of Christians. You go to some Christian houses, all kind of medicine they will have in their cupboard. Sickness is never coming from God. He said, for I know the thoughts I think towards you, thoughts of peace and not of evil. Sickness is an evil. Sickness is an evil. Prisoners of sickness. Wealthy people that cannot eat good food. They tell you don't put salt in food. So how can the food be sweet? There are people who can't eat salt in their food. Yet they are wealthy, they are rich. But the thing that should give taste to your food, they said you can't eat it. I pray for somebody that is a captive to sickness. I don't know which kind of sickness that they have seen in your body. I don't know what medically they have said concerning your health. I am not here to ask you to tell me the name of the sickness. Bible said that there is a name that at the mention of it, every other thing that has a name must bow. Therefore, I come with that name tonight. Whatever you are going through in the name of sickness, whether they are diabetes, whether they are gonorrhea, whether they are hepatitis B, whatever manner of sickness that is in your body, you are breaking out in the name of Jesus. Captives to sickness, captives to sin, and captives to Satan. There are people, they are captives to the devil himself. They are captives to the devil himself. I want to encourage you to pray. When you live in a house that the only time you started hearing things walking on top of your bed, on top of the roof of your house rather, my sister, you are captives of the devil. You can't have peace even in your rest. I've met people, sir, that if they close their eyes for just 5 minutes, they will see somebody chasing them. They can't sleep because they are captives to the devil. They sleep in the morning, they will have nightmare. They sleep in the noon, they will be chasing them. They sleep in the night, dogs will be after them. You are a captive of the devil. I don't know which kind of dream that the enemy is using to harass your life. I don't know what the enemy is showing you when you close your eyes to sleep. For your life to be fearful. For you to think that life will end for you very soon. I don't know the voice that is telling you that you will not live long. There is somebody listening to me. There is a voice that is speaking to you that you will not live long. That you will not live long. I come as a servant of God. I come with the voice of Jehovah tonight. Every wicked voice that is telling you that you will die untimely, I silence those voices in the name of Jesus. Every evil voice that is speaking death to your life, I command them to be silenced in the name of Jesus. I come to declare that you shall not die. I say you shall not die. I say you shall not die. Oh, there is somebody, you are not hearing me. I say you shall not die. If you are the one, I expect to be jumping and say, I shall not die. I speak to your life, you shall not die, my daughter. Oh, my son, you shall not die. That voice that said you would die, I command that voice to be silenced for today. You shall not die. You shall live to enjoy the fruit of your labor. You shall live to enjoy the fruit of your labor. So shall it be for you in the name of Jesus. Captives of the devil himself, telling them that life will not be long. Who is that bastard to tell me I will not live long? When God has said that with long life he will satisfy me, I can't die before my time. Wherever you are, lift up your hand, say, I shall not die. Say, but live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. Say, I shall not die. I shall live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. Say, as for me and my family, we shall not die. We shall live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. One more time, say, as for me and my family, we shall not die. We shall live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. That is the language of a child of God. As you have said it, you shall not die. I say, as you have said it, you shall not die. Captives of Satan, always reminding them that they will die early. Always telling them that you don't have long life. That voice can never come from God. God has no pleasure in the death of his saints. God has no pleasure in the death of a righteous man. So I come to speak to you tonight. If you are a captive of Satan, if you are a captive of sickness, if you are a captive of sin, whichever way you have been a captive, you are breaking out in Jesus' name. I say you are breaking out in Jesus' name. So I encourage you tonight to join me to pray. You break out of captivity by prayer. You break out of captivity by what?
By prayer.
You break out of captivity by agonizing well. It is in prayer that you decide to break out of captivity. 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verses 9 and 10. Bible tells us about a man by the name of Jabez. Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. Bible says he was honorable. He was an honorable man before God. But the Bible says the mother called his name Jabez. And because of his name, his life was full of sorrow. But Jabez came to a place of knowing that the only way he can break out of the camp of the devil is by prayer. And the Bible says, and Jabez called upon the God of Israel. I don't know if you want to do what Jabez did, but look at what Jabez did. He called. He did not complain to any man. He called unto the God of Israel. The only way you can break out of captivity is by prayer. Is by prayer. And when Jabez prayed, Bible says God granted him. Look at the last part. Look at the last part. He said, and God granted him that which he requested. There is a God here tonight to grant somebody your request. Oh, there is somebody watching me. There is somebody listening to me. I said there is a God that is here tonight to grant you your request. As you cried unto the God of Israel like Jabez, the same God who granted Jabez's request, may that same God grant you your request in the name of Jesus. You can break out of captivity in prayer. And I believe tonight, as you join me to pray, I see light coming all over your life again. I see light coming all over your life again. There is a fresh hope for you. Your future is not bleak. Your future is bright. Yeah, there is somebody listening to me. I say your future is not bleak. Your future is bright. You have a bright future. Oh, your days ahead of you, they are better and not bitter. I said the days ahead of you, they are better and not bitter. Your best is not in your past. Your best is ahead of you. May you enter your season of best in Jesus' name. Rise up on your feet wherever you are. We are going to cry unto him tonight. We are going to cry on him tonight. We are going to ask him to break us out of captivity. Forever you will be. Forever you will be the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, I humbly bow my knees. I humbly bow my knees as I worship you, Lord. Forever you will be my Lord, forever. The Lamb upon the throne. Oh, I humbly bow my knees. Humbly bow my knees as I walk. One more time. Forever you will be my Lord. Forever you will be. Ever you will be the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, I humbly bow my knees. I want us to pray, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. I have 5 prayers that we are going to pray tonight. I want to beg you to join me to pray these prayers very well. I want you to be desperate to go to God to pray tonight.
Because tonight the Lord said you are breaking out of every form of captivity, whether they are personal or they are collective. Yes, there is somebody listening to me, watching at me. You are breaking out of that captivity of smoking in the name of Jesus. You are breaking out of that captivity of immorality in the name of Jesus. You are breaking out of that captivity of lying in the name of Jesus. You are breaking out of that captivity of pornography in the name of Jesus. Join me to pray tonight. I beg you to join me to pray tonight. Are you ready to pray?
Yes, sir.
Psalm 126, like I said, says that when God turned again the captivity of Zion. This is going to be our first prayer point. And I say, Lord, turn my captivity around. Turn my captivity around. Lift up your voice and say, my Father, my God.
My Father, my God.
Say, my Father, my fighter.
My Father, my fighter.
As I pray tonight, oh God, my Father, turn my captivity around. Turn my family captivity around. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. In the name of Jesus. Turn my captivity around. Whether personal or collective. Every form of captivity. Turn it around tonight. Turn my captivity around. Whether personal or collective, let them be turned around. Whether personal or collective, let them be turned around. Whether personal or collective, turn my captivity around. Je de mesekeya. I jeta talamadokuse. Kere gada da da baje. Je tete le mesekeya. Turn my captivity around. 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 In the name of Jesus. Jenta la maduka se. Keleke tete bejela. Jida da na bazete. Jeka brose amanta. Ana la mantuka de. Zegodono mo zekete. Turn my captivity around. Turn my captivity around. Turn my captivity around. Every form of captivity, may you turn it around tonight. Every form of captivity. Wherever I am a prisoner, wherever I am in bondage, may you deliver me tonight and turn my captivity around. Whatever way I am in bondage, whatever way my family is in bondage, Father, set us free tonight. Set us free tonight. Mention your family name. Mention your family name. Ask God to set your family free tonight from every form of captivity. From every form of captivity. We bring the Bagua family before you. Turn our captivity around tonight. Turn the captivity around of the Bagua family. Set us free, God. 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 Turn our captivity around. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I still want to admonish somebody that is watching me. I want you to pray these prayers very well. If you don't pray them for yourself, pray them for your family. Maybe you are looking at me, you are watching at me, say, but my own case is better. I think I'm better than all of them. Thank God for your life. But hear me. When you are the only person that is free in your family, you are almost in bondage also. Because the burden and the pressure of the family will be upon you. And it is easy for you to enter the same bondage like them. But when others are out of the bondage, when others are also experiencing the freedom, you can have some amount of relief. Don't be glad when you are the richest, you are the only rich person in the family. I tell people, if you are the only person in a family that is rich, you are a poor man. You end up becoming a poor man because of the burden of the family. But when others are wealthy around you, life can be easy for you.
Are you ready to pray the second prayer?
Yes, sir.
Lift up your hand and your voice and say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very loud, say, my Father, my Fighter.
My Father, my Fighter.
As I pray tonight,
as I pray tonight.
Oh God, my Father,
oh, God, my
take
Father.
Me out of every captivity, whether personal or collective. Take me out of every captivity. Take my family out of every captivity. Whether they are personal, whether they are collective, take me out in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and you pray. Jata talama de kaseko, yega talama zata talama de bezo, je bezekete, karana na na boze breke sekete. Take me out of every captivity. Take me out of every captivity. Whether in a personal or collective, take me out of captivity. Take my family out of every captivity. Take my family out of every captivity. Take my family out of every captivity. Whether they are personal, whether they are collective, take my family out. Take my family out of every captivity. Of every captivity. Of every captivity. Take me out. Take my family out. Take me out. Take my family out. Take me out of every captivity. We are coming out. We are coming out. As an individual, I am coming out. As a family, we are coming out of every captivity. Captivities to sin, captivities to sickness, captivities to Satan. We are coming out in the name of Jesus. We are coming out. We are coming out. We are coming out. Je patoya anta kalaboje. Je getete igalegato. Je talemata ale katoka. Kele kele yama. Je dede. Take me out. Take my family out of every captivity. Take me out of every captivity. Take my family out of every captivity, of every bondage, of every imprisonment. We are coming out of every imprisonment, of every bondage. Take me out. Take my family out. Take me out, take my family out, take me out, take my family out of every bondage, of every imprisonment. We are coming out in the name of Jesus. We are coming out in the name of Jesus. We are coming out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Take my family out. Thank you, Father. Be glorified. Be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Talk to us. I want you to pray with me. I want you to pray very well. We have three more prayers. Talk to us. You are going to raise your voice tonight. And this is going to pray. This is going to be your prayer. You are going to say, Lord, I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. Every bondage of slavery. Listen to me. I said it earlier on. I repeat. You can be a slave to sin. I've met people that are engaged into things they don't like, but they can't stop. They are slaves to sin. We must walk in the liberty. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 1. Bible says, stand firm therefore in the liberty wherewith Christ had made us free. And be not entangled again in the yoke of bondage. I think Galatians. Give me Galatians 5. Galatians 5:1. Stand firm, therefore. Stand firm. Stand fast. Therefore, in the liberty. In God's liberty, wherewith Christ had made us free. We are not to walk in bondage, to be slaves to sin. We must stand fast in God's liberty. And the liberty, and be not entangled again. Yoke of bondage. There is a yoke called bondage. You can be a slave to sin. You can be a slave to sickness. I just told you just now. Do you know that there are some people, there are some things they like they can't do? There are some food they like eating, but because of sickness, they are forbidden to eat them. I break and loose myself from every form of slavery. lift up your voice and say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very loud, say, my Father, my Fighter.
My Father, my Father.
As I pray tonight,
as I pray,
I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. As I pray tonight, I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. I stand on behalf of my family. We are breaking ourselves out of every bondage of slavery. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. I break and lose myself from every bondage of slavery. Oh, from every bondage of slavery. I break and lose myself from every bondage of slavery. I break and lose myself. I walk in God's liberty. I walk in God's liberty. I stand fast in God's liberty. I stand fast in Christ's liberty. I stand fast in Christ's liberty. I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. I break and loose myself from every bondage of slavery. I stand representing my family. We break and loose ourselves from every bondage of slavery. Whatever had made my family a slave, we are breaking out of that slavery. We are coming out in the name of Jesus. We break and lose ourselves from every bondage of slavery. We break and lose ourselves from every bondage of slavery in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Second to last prayer we are going to pray tonight. I love this prayer. Oh, I love this prayer. Listen to the prayer point. Every journey into captivity, I terminate you from today. There is a journey into captivity.
Yes.
Solomon said, for there is a way that seemeth right unto a man. He said, but the end leads to destruction. That journey is a journey to captivity.
Yes,
it looks blue, so it looks good, it looks bright. But the trap is at the end. Every journey into captivity.
Yes.
And listen to me now. Some of those journey can be relationship.
Yes.
I don't know who I'm talking to. It can be some relationship you are into. It is a journey into captivity. There are some men you meet in life. You have entered a journey into captivity. We have many people who are married today. But whenever they think of their marriage, they are full of regrets. Some people get married to have pleasure. Some people are into marriage and they are full of pressure. Pressure. Some people are married today,
But they wish they were single, because their journey started the day they entered the life of that particular person. Every journey into captivity, as a reason of my prayer tonight, I terminate you by the blood of Jesus. Say, my Father, my fighter. As I pray tonight, every journey into captivity, by reason of my prayer tonight, by the blood of Jesus, every journey into captivity, I terminate you tonight by the blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. I bring an end to you. Every journey into captivity, I bring an end to you. I bring an end to you from tonight. I bring an end to you from tonight. Every journey that leads to captivity, every journey that leads to imprisonment, every journey that leads to slavery, I terminate you tonight in the name of Jesus. Je katana mandokose, je de bezekete. Every journey that leads to captivity, I terminate it tonight. I terminate it tonight. I terminate it tonight. Every journey that will lead me to slavery, that will lead me to imprisonment, that will lead me to bondage, from tonight, I terminate you. I terminate you. I terminate you. I bring an end to 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 you. Every journey that leads to captivity, as I pray tonight, I bring an end to you in the name of Jesus. I bring an end to you. I bring an end to you. I bring an end to you. I bring an end to you in the name of Jesus. Every journey that leads to captivity, I bring an end to you from tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Bless you, God. Give you praise and glory. Be magnified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. There is somebody watching at me now. The Spirit of God is saying that as I'm talking now, you are weeping in your heart. You are crying in your heart. Because you are saying, Pastor, you are talking to me. You are saying, Pastor, you are talking to me. I want you to make sure you get up to me after. We need to talk. I've met people like that. That their journey into captivity started the day they accepted some people in their lives. Their journey to bondage began the day they opened door to some kind of friendship, to some kind of relationship. There are some people, the day you accept them into your life as a friend, your downfall will start. Some of you know what I'm talking about. Make sure you contact me personally so that we can talk. This is a public forum. Make sure you contact me personally because I want to pray for you. I want to pray with you. This is our last prayer for tonight. I believe God is speaking to somebody. I believe God is speaking. God is ministering to the heart of somebody. This is our final prayer. Our final prayer for tonight. I want you to lay your hand on your chest. Lay your hand on your chest wherever you are. Lay your hand on your chest. And this is going to be your prayer. Say, my Father, my God. Say it with life. Say, my Father, my God. As I pray tonight, any power using my blood for evil assignment,
any satanic power that is using my blood for evil assignment, as I pray tonight, be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. Lift up your voice. Any power from the pit of hell that is using my blood for evil assignments, lose your hold now. Be destroyed. Lose your grip. Lose your hold. 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 Lose your grip. Any wicked power that is using my blood for evil assignment, let them lose their hold. Let them lose their grip over my life. Ikaboshete. Je denebezekete. Igalabajota lama de kaseke. Kereda da 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 baji. Je denebezekete. Je denebezekete. Je denebezekete. Lose your grip. Lose your hold. Lose your grip. Lose your hold. Lose your grip. Lose your hold. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every wicked satanic power that is using your blood for evil assignment, every satanic power, every wicked power that is using your blood, using the blood of your children for evil assignment, from today, let them lose their grip over your life. Let them be destroyed. Let those powers be destroyed. Let those powers be neutralized. Let those powers be frustrated. Let those powers be canceled in the name of Jesus. Lose your hold. Lose your grip. Lose your hold. Lose your grip. Using my blood for evil assignment. Using the blood of my children for evil assignment. As I pray tonight, wherever you are, I command your blood bank to be dried up. Let your blood bank be dried up. Let your blood bank be dried up. Let your blood bank be dry up. Every witchcraft altar, satanic altar, marine altar, occultic altar, or serpentine altar, where the blood of my children are being kept for evil assignments, where they kept my blood for evil assignments, scatter my fire, scatter my fire, scatter my fire. Jadada da bazoto lokote, igala mantoka bazeti. Je de mes écoutes. Je te la bagaze katai. Je de mes écoutes. Je m'assata la banda mazo. Yaga yege de mes écoutes. Je blesse te de gede yama. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be. Stretch your hand before you. Stretch your hand before you. Stretch your hand right before you. I want to pray for you tonight. And that is the one prayer I want to pray that we ended with. Bible said the life of a thief is in the blood. Blood is very important. That's why all manner of sickness in this world is connected to the blood. All manner, including coronavirus, is connected to the blood. Every manner of sickness has a connection to your blood. I pray for you as you are watching me. I don't know who I am talking to, that they are using your blood for their evil assignment. They are using the blood of your children for their evil assignment. That is why it is you are well today, the next day you are feeling sick. That is why you are strong today, the other day you are feeling weak. I pray for you today. Every wicked altar that is using your blood for their evil assignment, I command those altars to catch fire in the name of Jesus. Stretch your hand before you. Antabru zikadara baza. If I be a man of God, I pray for you tonight. You are marching out of that captivity in Jesus' name. Amen. I say you are marching out of every form of captivity in the name of Jesus. Amen. Whether they are personal or collective. Yes, sir. If they are personal, I see you marching out free in Jesus' name. Amen. If they are collective, I see you gathering, putting together your family members. I see all of you marching out of evil captivity in the name of Jesus. The grace of God will march you out of evil captivity. As it happened for Paul and Silas, when they prayed at midnight, it will happen for somebody tonight. As it happened for Paul and Silas, when they prayed at midnight, it is happening for somebody tonight in the name of Jesus. You march out of that captivity. You are coming out of that imprisonment. You are being delivered from that form of slavery. And every bondage you are into, you are coming out in Jesus' name. You are coming out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for tonight. Let your name be glorified. Let your name be praised. Let your name be magnified. Come on, lift up your voice and give him glory. Lift up your voice and bless him for tonight. Bless him for tonight. Bless him for tonight. Give him all the praise. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. Give him every adoration. Let his name be glorified. Come on, somebody bless him. Bless him. Thank you for tonight. Thank you for bringing me out of every captivity. Thank you for bringing my family out of every captivity. Thank you for bringing my children out of every captivity. Thank you, mighty God. Let your name be magnified. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Be glorified.
There is something that makes me run into your presence. There is something that makes me run into your presence, my helper. You are my helper, oh, my helper. Something that makes me run into your presence, my helper. You are my helper, oh,
my helper.
On top of your head, rest your two hands on top of your head and quietly in your heart tell God, say, God, there is something that makes me come to you. I need a change. I need this change. I need you to complete me. I need you to settle me. Right in your heart. Nobody needs to hear you as you pray. The song said there is something. I don't know. If you don't have, don't pray. If you don't have anything coming to God for, then you have to be quiet. But if you know that there is an issue in your life that you are trusting God to settle, if you know that there is something around you that you are believing God to address, why can't you quietly talk to Him? There is something, Papa. There is something that makes me want into your presence. There is a reason why I have come tonight. There is a reason why we decide to come tonight. There is a reason why we choose to come and to call unto you this moment, Father. Father, visit us. Visit our families. Settle our case. Settle our matter. Change our story, Papa. Change our story, Papa. Do the impossible, Daddy. Do the impossible, Father. Do the impossible. 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 Do the impossible, Father. Do the impossible, Daddy. Do the impossible in my life. Many people said it will never happen. A lot of people say it will never happen. But Father, there is nothing you cannot do. There is nothing. Is anything too hard for the Lord? You make a way in the wilderness. You can cause rivers to flow from desert places. Father, please, don't let me go the same way I came. Somebody tell him that. Don't let me go the same way I came. Don't let me go the same way I came. Touch me with your hand. Touch me with your hand. Touch me with your hand. Visit my life. Like you visited Hannah. Visit my life. Like you visited Sarah. Visit my life. Like you visited Elizabeth. Visit the life of that lady, Father. Visit the life of that young girl. Visit the life of that young man. Visit the life of somebody, Father. We pray for your divine visitation. Visit us. Visit us. Turn our lives around. Change our story. You are good at turning again. When the Lord turn again, Father, we ask that you turn again. Turn again our captivities around. Turn it again. Turn it again. For our good. For our good. For our pleasure. Turn our captivities around for our own pleasure. For our own good. Turn it around for us. Turn it around for us. May we turn all the glory, all the praise, all the honor and adoration unto you. Let your name be magnified. Thank you, Father, for everything. Be glorified. Be glorified. Thank you. Be glorified. Be glorified. Be glorified. He is not a man that he should lie. Not the son of man that he should repent. What he say he will do, that is what he will do. That word is going for somebody. Fear not. Fear not. Fear not. Age has nothing to do with what I want to do. Forget about your age. Forget about your age. Forget about your age. Age has nothing to do with what I am about to do. I am the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me? I am the God of all flesh. I will do it. I will do it. I will do it. I will complete your life. I will complete you. I will complete you. Those who said it will never happen, they have said their own. I, the Lord, I will complete you. I will complete you. I will perfect that which concerns you. I will perfect that which concerns you. I see your heart. I see your burden. I see your longing. I see your desire. I will perfect that which concerns you. I will bring them to pass. You can't labor in vain for me. You can't serve me in vain. You can't serve me in vain. You can't work for me in vain. I will perfect that which concerns you. And I will settle your life. I will give you a joy that you will never cease to laugh. I will give you a joy that you will never cease to laugh. I will put a joy in your mouth that you will never cease to rejoice. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for tonight. We honor you. Bless us abundantly. Thank you for your word that we have received. We receive it with meekness. We receive it in faith. Be glorified. Thank you for everything. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. We want to appreciate God for your life.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are done for tonight. God bless you again for connecting with us. We keep encouraging you to keep connecting with us and keep sharing this page to others. Please, keep sharing this page to others. I don't know why I'm still insisting on it day by day. There are many of you watching at me. There are people who are connected to you. There are people who are close to you. These are things that they need to be hearing. These are prayers that they need to be praying. Please, I encourage you, connect this page to others and let people connect to this vision and ministry, and things will turn for their good in the name of Jesus. God bless you, God bless you, and God bless you. See you on Sunday again. Shalom.